Hello and Namaste. Welcome to bhavanaskitchen.com. Today I'm making pork dokla. Pork is basically tender jowar available during November to January in India, and it's very popular where I grew up in Gujarat. It's basically green sorghum. So let's start. Night before, prepare dokla batter. I have already shared how to prepare dokla common mix at home. You just need to grind rice and Bengal gram. So this is the one way of preparing dokla. The other way of preparing dokla is some people just soak rice and dal and then grind next day and let it ferment. So there are two ways of preparing dokla. I find this way easier. If my next morning is very busy, all I have to do is just prepare the batter day before. So I always keep dokla common ready mix in my pantry. And I have already shared how you can prepare all these mixes at home easily. 1 cup of dokla mix, 1/4 cup of coarsely ground pork mix. Here I have boiling water. Also, I'm going to add about 1/2 cup of yogurt and give it a good mix now and add water as needed. I'm going to add slightly little bit more water. At this point, I'm not going to add anything else. Cover it. Once you prepare the batter, allow it to ferment for about 6 to 8 hours or overnight. Now, if you don't have pork, don't worry, you can use even green peas or some other grains if desired. So it's totally up to you, or simply you can just leave it out. Now I'm going to steam dokla. First, I'm going to prepare dokla tray. Grease the tray with oil, bottom, sides, everywhere properly. And remember, I did not add any spices or anything in this dokla batter. So now it's time to add everything and ready to steam. Take about 1 liter of water into the steamer. I'm going to heat up the steamer on a high heat so the water starts boiling, because we need a hot boiling water when you put dokla tray into the steamer. And into this batter now, ready to add ginger and green chili paste. You can add as per your taste. Just a pinch of a turmeric powder, salt to taste, oil about 2 tablespoons, ground peanut, mungfali. Ground peanut is optional. Mix of coriander and a cumin powder, dhania jeera powder. Give it a good mix. And here I got whole pork. Just to give a hint that this dokla is made of a pork, I prefer to add a little bit of a whole pork as well. And since my pork is not fresh, it's not real green, so I'm adding this dhania chutney, cilantro or coriander leaves chutney, to get a little green color. But it's totally optional. And now the last thing I have to add is, in order to make this dokla nice and spongy and soft, I add Eno brand fruit salt. If you don't have, you can find at any Indian grocers, or you can use baking soda or baking powder, but I usually prefer to add Eno brand fruit salt. So add about 1 teaspoon of Eno. You can see how it bubbles up. That's the sign that it is fresh and working. Just a little bit of a lemon juice. Give it a good stir. All right, so now this batter is completely ready. My steamer is ready. And pour this batter into the dokla tray. On the top, I'm going to sprinkle sesame seeds till. This is must on Gujarati doklas. Okay, I can already hear the steamer. So this tray is ready to go into the steamer. Carefully open the steamer and place the tray carefully. Cover it and steam for about 20 minutes. And while dokla is steaming, I'm going to prepare tadka, tempering basically. Heat up oil. About 2 tablespoons of oil. When the oil is hot, add mustard seeds, rye. When it starts spluttering, cover to prevent the mess.
and turn off the stove now.
Dogla has been steaming for about 20 minutes. I'm going to turn off the stove and do not open yet. Let it allow to cool down a little bit.
Let's open up the steamer. And look at this dogla. Safely remove the dogla tray and put it onto the hot plate. Cut dogla. Run your knife on the edges first, then cut however you like, square, diamond. Sprinkle coriander leaves on top. I'm just going to sprinkle on one side because I have some picky kids in my house who do not like coriander leaves. And then pour the tarka on the top. Lift dough glass carefully. Arrange onto the plate. Perfect.
Time to bite. So this was about preparing pork dogla. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great recipe.